everyone. Welcome to the tutorial video. So in this video, let us consider a matrix representation of a linear transformation. So suppose I am considering my matrix to be like this, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. And I am saying that this is the matrix representation of T for some linear transformation T, and my ordered basis which I have taken, let us consider it as beta, which is nothing but 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, and 1, 0, 1. So with respect to this ordered basis for some linear transformation T, I am getting my matrix representation of this linear transformation to be this A matrix. So I can write it as T with respect to beta. So beta for both domain and codomain. I am considering this order basis in both the sides. Okay. Now my question is, what will be the matrix representation of T, the matrix representation of T with respect to standard ordered basis. This is of R3. So here what we are doing, everything is in R3. So standard ordered basis of R3 is nothing but 1 0 0 0 1 0 and 0 0 1. Okay. So we have to find the matrix representation of T with respect to standard ordered basis. And so what we do, we will start with this given representation. So here observe that T 1 1 0 is nothing but 0 into 1 1 0 plus 0 into 0 1 1 plus 0 into 1 0 1. So with respect to this ordered basis beta, with this beta, if I express this first vector T 1 1 0, then I am getting the coefficient for these vectors as 0, 0 and 0, and that's what come in this column. So as this first column is nothing but 0, 0, 0, so the image of this first vector 1, 1, 0 should be 0. That's what the matrix representation is. So similarly, the second column is also 0. So the image of 0, 1, 1 is again the same thing, 0 into 1 1 0 plus 0 into 0 1 1 and 0 into 1 0 1, again it will be 0. And what about the third one? The third column is 0 0 1. So if I take this last vector 1 0 1, so for the first element it will be 0, because 0 is in the first position of the first row of the third column. So, and the second is also 0, but the third will be 1. That's why we get 0, 0, 1 in the third column. So, it will give us 1, 0, 1. So, this is 0 means 0, 0, 0, 0, as we are considering in R3. So, these are the images of the given vectors in beta. So what we get here, just we will write just in the next page. So let us write what we have got here. T of 1 1 0, that is 0. T of 0 1 1, that is again 0. And T of 1 0 1, this is 1 0 1, the same vector. So this we have got. Now what we have to do, we have to express the standard ordered basis with respect to this ordered basis. So basically what we have to do, we have to express 1, 0, 0, the first vector in the standard ordered basis in terms of these vectors of beta. So let me write, express 1, 0, 0 as a linear combination of these three vectors. So this will be like this expression. So it is a plus c, a plus b, and b plus c. So a plus c will be 1, a plus b will be 0, and b plus c will be 0 again. So if we solve these three equations, then we get our a to be half, b to be minus half, and c to be half. If we solve these three equations, you will get this as a solution. This is a unique solution. So yeah, so 1, 0, 0 is nothing but half of this first vector 1, 1, 0 minus half of the second vector 0, 1, 1 plus half of this third vector, that is 1, 0, 1. So we can express 1, 0, 0 in terms of these vectors in beta. Similarly, we can do for others. So others I am just writing here 0, 1, 0. It will be half of 1, 1, 0 plus half of 0, 1, 1 minus half of 1, 0, 1. And for the last one, 0, 0, 1 is nothing but minus half of 1, 1, 0 plus half 0, 1, 1 plus half 1, 0, 1. So we express all the three vectors in standard ordered basis in terms of the basis which was given was beta. So we got this expression. Now what we have to do, we have to apply t here. So we have to find the image of t 1, 0, 0. Similarly, we have to find t of 0, 1, 0 and t of 0, 0, 1. Okay, now if we apply t on 1, 0, 0 in this expression, so t is a linear transformation, so we can take this scalar out and it will be t half into 1, 1, 0 minus half into t of 0, 1, 1 and half into t of 1, 0, 1. So for the first two vectors, t of 1, 1, 0, that is 0, t of 0, 1, 1, that is again 0. So it is nothing but half into t of 1, 0, 1, which is the same t of 1, 0, 1. So we get this vector. Similarly, for the other two, we can calculate that t of 0, 1, 0 is again minus half of 1, 0, 1. And t of 0, 0, 1 is half of 1, 0, 1. Okay, so this we got. Now any vector xyz can be written as x into 1, 0, 0 plus y into 0, 1, 0 plus z into 0, 0, 1. So this we can do. So t of xyz is nothing but x of t of 1, 0, 0. Again, we are using the properties of linear transformation and we are getting this t of 0, 1, 0 plus z into t of 0, 0, 1. So if we write this, if we put the values of t of 1, 0, 0 which we have calculated, so we get x into half into 1, 0, 1 minus y into half into y, 0, 1 plus z into half 1, 0, 1. So if we calculate this together and put all the things together, we will get half into x minus y plus z 0 x minus y plus z. So this is the expression for t of x, y, z which we are intended to find. Now we want to find the matrix representation of t with respect to standard order basis. So for standard order basis, t of 1, 0, 0 we already have got the image, so we can just express it in terms of standard order basis, and we'll get this half into 1, 0, 0 plus 0 into 0, 1, 0 plus half into 0, 0, 1. Similarly for the second one, it will be just minus half in these two places and 0 in the middle one. So this is 0, 0, 1. And similarly for the third one, again it will be half into 1, 0, 0 plus 0 into 0, 1, 0 plus half into 0, 0, 1. So the matrix representation we got here with respect to standard order basis will be half, 0, half, minus half, 0, minus half, half, 0, half. So this will be the matrix representation with respect to standard order basis of the given matrix which we have started. Now for the same linear transformation, which is tx, y, z is going to half of x minus y plus z, 0, x minus y plus z. For this linear transformation, if we want to visualize the kernel, so what we have to do, basically this image should kernel will be all those vectors x, y, z, so that the image will be 0. So if the image will be 0, we get x minus y plus z equal to 0, and that will give us y equal to x plus z. So all these vectors x, y, z such that y equal to x plus z, and everything is from real, xz is from real, then this vector space is our kernel of t. So this is our kernel of t. So what will be the basis of this kernel? So there are two independent variables, x and z. So we can get kernel as the span of these two vectors. So if we put x, if we put 1 in place of x, we will get 1, 1, 0, and if we put 1 in place of z and 0 in place of x, we will get 0, 1, 1. So these two span of these two vectors will be our kernel of t. So this is our kernel of t. So you can also calculate this by using row operations on this matrix what we have got here. If we can do the row operation, you will again see that the one vector will be dependent variable and two are independent variables. So kernel will be of dimension 2 and it will be spanned by these two vectors. And so now if we can go back earlier from where we have started, we can see that for the first two vectors of this basis beta, this 1, 1, 0 and 0, 1, 1, for these two vectors the image is nothing but 0. So that we have written here, these 2 hectares, for these 2 hectares the image are going to be 0, and for the last one the image is the same vector. So for span of these two first vectors 1,1,0 and 0,1,1 will form a these 2 hectares will form a basis of kernel of T. So that we have seen in this example. Okay, now let us try to visualize this thing in GeoGebra. So now if in three-dimensional plane, in R3, if we choose the vector -4,6,3, which we are seeing in the figure, in the diagram, then the image of this will be this new vector, which we are seeing, that is -3.5,0, -3.5. So now if we change the vectors there, we will see the image will also change here. Okay. Now, if we only consider the vectors of this form, of form such that x comma y comma z, such that y equal to x plus z, which we have seen that is the kernel of the transformation. So how the vectors will look like? Yeah. So for that thing, the vectors will look like this, and in that case, if we choose all the vectors in this form, as we can see, so -2,3,5. So that means 5 + -2, that will give us 3. So the second coordinate is basically the sum of the first coordinate and the third coordinate. If we consider these vectors only, then the image will always be 0. So if we vary these, all this form of vectors, all these kind of vectors which are in this kernel, we will see that the image will be nothing but 0. So all these vectors which are of this form will lie in the plane, as you can see here, it will lie in the plane. Yeah, as you can see, this all these vectors are on the same plane, and the plane is nothing but x minus y plus z equal to 0, that is y equal to x plus z. So all these vectors will lie in the plane, and the image of these vectors will be 0. So this plane is basically the kernel of this linear transformation. So this is a two-dimensional vector space passing through origin, and so this is the geometrical representation of the kernel. Thank you.